看看新闻网。
Welcome to Ways to Wellness. I'm He Jian. This is a show that guides you to the best ways to get well and stay well. We are giving you a fair stage on which to demonstrate both traditional Chinese medicine and Western medicine solutions. But we just show the different options. You are the one to decide which is the best treatment for you. Today we will talk about 24-hour body clock, and we have two guests with us. We have Dr. Queenie Mei of Western Medicine and Mr. Li Wenyou, expert in traditional Chinese medicine. Li Wenyou is a famous expert in traditional Chinese medicine. He has been a guest on many health programs in Shanghai. Queenie Mei is an American trained doctor of medicine. She is the member of Institute of Functional Medicine and has received the USA President Award in Functional Medicine in 2010. On the previous episode, our two experts introduced tips on staying healthy from 11 p.m. to 1 p.m. Today, we will talk about the other half of the 24-hour body clock cycle. Evan, an American who studied traditional Chinese medicine for over 8 years, will join our discussion. Also, famous TV host Ye Ying asks for our help. He's been struggling with stress since he began taking care of his new baby recently. Now let's continue our discussion on how to stay healthy from 1 p.m. to 11 p.m. 好了，我们现在午觉也已经睡好了。那么我们现在开始谈一点到三点。
对，一点到三点呢，我们这个中国传统上把它叫胃食。吃完午饭以后，这个午饭也得去把它给消化掉啊。所以呢，我又说我们这个身体是非常智能的。这个时候是一个哪个经络在循行？是小肠经。我们学生理卫生都知道，小肠是主管消化的。我们的食物到了小肠里面，经过小肠的吸收，营养就进入我们的血液，通过血液循环把营养带到我们的全身去。那中医呢讲什么叫分清别浊，什么意思呢？小肠干什么？分清别浊，我们有个词叫分别嘛，分别就这么来的，分清别浊。
哦，把清的和浊的
给它分别开。水液往膀胱里面走，然后呢这个燥魄往大肠里面走，小肠下面接了大肠嘛，然后呢营养精华就到了我们的脾里面了，通过脾，哎，我们上午讲过，脾这个活儿，它这个虽然不是脾经循行，它一点点干这个事儿的，再把它送到我们这个全身去。
小肠就像一个管理员一样，负责分配，
对，它负责把这些东西分配掉。
它是老师，它分配。
对，那么这个胃食过了以后呢，就是申食。
申食就是三点到五点。
对，下午的三点到五点。那么这个是我们哪条经络在值班呢？干活呢？是我们的膀胱经。这膀胱经管什么呢？我们知道是管我们的小便的，
对，要上厕所了，
哎，要小便。这个时候呢，我们身体的这个精液啊，这个精是三点水天精的精啊，我们的精液呢处在一天当中最混沌的时候啊，所以呢膀胱经要干什么呢？要把这些浑浊的精液给它排掉。所以这个时候我们要干什么事情呢？我们一定要喝一点水。因为你这个三点到五点啊，它是一个时间段，只要你进入这个时间段，开始三点钟你开始有意识多喝一点水就可以了，
它其实会排泄比较快一点，
对，
能这样理解吗？
排泄比较快，也排泄比较彻底。
哎呦，现在3:15，中医上说啊，哎，这个时间得要补水，为什么要补水呢？哎，它有一种这个分清别浊的作用啊，就是分离干净的，完了呢去除污垢的。哎，我们这儿准备了很海量的水啊。其实喝水的功效啊，我个人觉得不光是解渴，而且可以排毒，更可以起掉这个清流与活源的作用。其实人体啊，它就是一个循环呐、啊。你这水补充的干净了以后，哎，这个源头也就自然就活起来了。
So drinking water is very important. It's the basis of our body. Mostly, you should probably have 8 cups, and a cup is about this much. So 8 of these a day.
那我们知道，这个排出这个混沌的这个精液，除了小便以外，还有一个途径。就是排汗，而且呢我们前面小肠经吸收营养之后呢，我们的这时候能量也是比较充沛的，所以呢我是非常推崇我们一天当中运动，如果要选一个时间的话，我是非常赞成在这个时辰里面去运动的。
3点到5点，
对，下午3点到5点的话是一天当中我自己特别珍惜这个时间，一方面珍惜这个时间去排毒，另外一方面我们说这个时候呢脑子也清楚，精力也旺盛， 我们上午说过，上午的九点到十一点是一天当中很重要的一个工作的时间。下午三点到五点也是一个工作的重要的时间。
I walk a lot, like I said, I have a dog, and I usually walk him 3 to 4 hours every day, and I also ride my bike everywhere in Shanghai, and I go to the gym, and lift weights, and I do Tai Chi.
首先，我本身就是中长跑的运动员。那么跑步的话呢，其实对于这个身体的一天的精神健康状况都会有很大的好处。
Queenie, you mentioned that before 9 a.m. it's a very good time for we to do exercises.、Mm-hmm. But I think there is some contradiction between your theories. Like in traditional Chinese medicine theory, the best time for exercises、mm-hmm. is、from 3 p.m. to、mm-hmm. 5 p.m.、Mm-hmm. But in your theory, it is before 9 a.m. So、mm-hmm. who's correct?
Well,、one thing is, based on the adrenal、hormone balance-wise, and、you do have the highest energy in the morning. However, based on the biomeridian testing, around 5 o'clock, the body hits the highest level of the brain capacity, the muscle, and the nervous system, the highest level. So if you do want to go work out around that time, you will probably have a good record.
Okay.
But,、based on the biomeridian or the hormone testing,、it's probably still not a bad idea to use a lot of energy towards the morning, because at nighttime is actually you're supposed to go home and rest. I would say if you do want to exercise, don't go later than 7.
Okay, I see.
生食过去之后，就是下午的5点到7点钟。
嗯，
这个呢，我们叫酉时。有时呢是我们的肾经值班的时候，经过了你一下午的忙碌之后，那这个时候应该干什么呢？应该是稍微调整休整一下的时候。
啊，这个时候是我们下班吃饭的时候。
这个时候肾是管什么呢？肾是在这个时候是它的负责是把我们一天脏腑的精华给它储存起来
啊。
所以呢，这个时候呢，我们要让自己处在一种安静的休整的一个状态。
那我们很多人肾亏啊，肾虚，是不是因为在5点和7点这一个时间段里面没有管理好自己的肾？
应该讲呢，造成肾虚的原因有很多。
嗯，
但是你如果要补肾的话，这个时候是比较好的。那怎么补肾呢？也有很多的方法，比方说通过食疗的方法，也可以通过一些经络穴位按摩啊，一些功法也是很好的。比方说，我有一个很简单的方法，也可以跟大家去这个分享啊。你看我们这个背部啊，腰这个位置啊，在我们皮带的上方啊，脊柱的两侧有两个穴位叫肾腧穴，
嗯，
它是我们膀胱经上的两个穴位，
嗯，
那么我们可以把我们的手啊，做成两个拳头，
嗯，
然后用我们这个泉眼的地方，
泉眼
放在这个肾腧穴上面，然后你就上下这样的摩擦，啊，那我可以做的酷一点，就是说我一边踮脚尖一边摩擦，那这样的话让它相对运动啊。过一会儿你就感觉到这个肾腧穴呢，暖暖的、热热的，那就起到补肾的作用。
我也来试试啊，就是站起来以后呢，用自己的这个食指啊，包括这个中指，还有这个大拇指呢，三个指箍住这边腰间，然后顶住自己左右2公分的这个所谓的叫肾腧的位置啊。
通常古人是在这个酉时吃晚饭的，
嗯，
但是跟现代人不同的是，
对，
他们晚饭吃的非常少，
哦，
非常简单。为什么呢？我跟你一讲你就明白了。我们早饭几点钟吃？7点钟吃。我们吃完早饭谁在值班呢？胃在值班。胃值完班以后呢，嗯，这个我们的脾又干活。我们中饭什么时候吃呢？12点吃。吃完以后谁干活呢？我们的小肠干活。请问晚饭吃完以后还有没有跟消化有关的器官干活呢？
啊，没有。
没有
啊。
你能晚饭多吃吗？
啊，
所以我们身体的这个智能系统它天然的就是让你晚饭少吃的。
嗯，
接下来我们是心包经和这个和我们这个三焦经，晚上一直到睡觉之前他们都不管消化的。
嗯，
你吃的多怎么办？从这个角度来讲，晚饭也是紧紧果腹，让自己觉得不太饿就可以了。
啊，
看我们现代人大吃大喝，
对，因为晚饭是重点。
对，所以呢，违反我们身体这个机器的智能。
So Queenie, what would you like to add to this part?
we said earlier is that we don't want to exercise later than 7 o'clock. Mm-hmm. So if you get up around 5, 5:30, that's most common working hours, then you should probably start thinking about dinner. And if you want to do exercise, maybe around that time, but you got to balance between the exercise and also the dinner time. So it's not too much food in your stomach. Usually the heaviest meal, it should be a lunch. So lunch should be your biggest, heaviest meal of the day. So the largest meal should be around lunchtime. Mm-hmm. There is a study that has been done with 2,000 calories that's consumed in a day. If you consume the most majority of the 2,000 calories towards morning and lunch, you will actually have more weight loss compared to the person who put more calorie towards the night and lunch, and you will actually gain more weight. Mm. So that's another smart way to think about how to plan your meals throughout the day.
好了，我们已经说了几个小时，20个小时了。我们还剩4个小时，2个时辰，就是晚上7点到11点。
对。那我们刚刚讲的这个有时到晚上7点钟，那接下来就是7点钟到9点钟晚上，这个是。哪一条经络值班呢？是我们的心包经。心包这个概念呢，是中医的一个特有的一个概念，它就是我们心脏的一层保护膜。它的意思就是说我心脏非常非常重要。中医讲是我们的君主之官，我们的五脏六腑里面它是地位最高的。
它是帝王。
所以要保护它。那里有一层膜，它叫什么？叫带菌受邪，就是说你如果有这个邪气要侵害我的话。我就像一个城墙一样，把这个
铜墙铁壁、
皇帝给保护起来。我们这个心包啊，它最好的状态就是开心的状态，这样就会帮助心包经啊清除侵害我们心脏的这些邪，保护我们的心脏。
那我们怎么知道它开心不开心呢？
不是啥意思的，就是说你到了心包经循行的时候，它的功能是清除我们对我们心脏有潜在威胁的这些毒害，那么他的工作在这2个小时里就完成了。那怎么样帮助他呢？就是你要保持一种开心的状态，就帮到他了。所以呢，我们晚上7点到9点钟时候，我们应该做一些让自己开心的事情。我的理解是做一些轻松愉快的娱乐活动。我觉得我们现代人呢，往往呢这个时辰呢倒是做对了。你看，我们经常会把娱乐安排在这段时间，
对呀。
所以我就说，我们现在人经常是12个时辰啊，只有一个时辰是对的，就是这个7点到9点是对的，就大家往往在这个时候是做一些开心的事情的。但是要提醒一点，虽然要做开心的事情，但是呢，我们接下来马上到了亥时就要准备睡觉了。
对呀，不能开心过头。
不能做一些很嗨的事情，嗨到过头了，完蛋了，你到接下来安静不下来了。所以我说要做一些轻松愉快的事情，不是那种剧烈开心的事情，这个也不行的。这就是这个时辰要做的事情。
野英 gets off work at 7 p.m. What does he do to unwind from the stress of the day?
直播刚刚结束，可以稍微的缓冲一下。其实大家伙听过我节目都知道，5点到7点这2个小时的节目，其实就像是一个大的片花。你基本上是属于一个无缝的状态在进行工作。其实我最好的放松方法，一般大家伙都知道，我就是在直播完了以后喝杯咖啡。喝咖啡呢有两种，一种去店里喝，一种在办公室喝。在办公室喝，你知道，就是成本比较低。
那么到了亥时，就是9点到11点的时候，我们说11点钟你要睡着觉的，
对呀。
所以实际上你入睡的那个时间是在亥时的。中医讲亥时啊，是我们这个百脉安静的状态。就是说，你身体所有的经脉在这个时候啊，都应该慢慢安静下来了。
打坐吧。
所以你一过9点钟呢，倒不一定打坐了。当然了，你说的很对，很多人在睡前是打坐的。但是你过了9点钟之后呢，你原则上就不应该看那个让你看了大哭流涕的电视剧，对吧？不应该看让那个紧张的不得了的球赛，不应该看那个就是让你这个。情绪剧烈波动的一个文学作品，这样你慢慢就安静下来了，你的百脉呢，对你百脉的修养啊是最好的，人呢一点一点可以进入到这个睡眠的状态，所以呢叫亥时通百脉，百脉开始修养，这是9点到11点之间干的事情。这一天我们就过完了。当子时再次来临的时候，你应该是酣睡于榻上，这就是一个健康的人生。
So Queenie, what would you like to say about the last 4 hours of the day? As I was saying in the beginning of the show, around 9 o'clock is when the melatonin starts being secreted. So around that time, you should start thinking about going to rest and relax. However, the Western medicine didn't have too much idea about the happy time, the happy hours. Maybe it was prolonged at a later hours, mm-hmm. per se. Around 9 o'clock, you start resting, reading a book, things like that. Don't do anything too excited. Mm-hmm. So in that sense, we're basically concurring with the Chinese doctor.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. 有，现在我们已经达成一个共识，就是11点的话，我们就得睡觉。Mm-hmm. 不管是中医还是西医，11点就一定要让自己进入梦乡。现在我们有很多人啊，就入睡很难。就他上床以后啊，快则半小时，慢则要两三小时，都没法入睡。Mm-hmm. 那有没有什么小的技巧可以帮助我们啊？10点半上床，然后有什么就可以做一下？一刻钟以后，半小时以后就可以进入梦乡了。
我们晚上睡觉前可以吃点什么东西呢？或者晚饭的时候吃一点莲子做的食品，比方说莲子粥。莲子是帮助睡眠的，比方说吃一点百合做的食品，百合帮助睡眠的。我们中医还有一个叫酸枣仁儿，这是一个药食同源的，也可以帮助睡眠的。所以呢，通过这些方法呢，能够使我们尽快的入睡。
So Queenie, I would like to hear your opinion.
Sure. Many ways that to help sleeping would be simple as taking something relaxing your body, such as magnesium. Many times you can take magnesium and calcium powder to help you to relax, and the next day to have very, very good bowel movement as well. And you can also take some herbal products, such as like valerian root and things like that, that will really calm your nerves and help you to fall asleep. Especially like the doctor said, during the day, your brain is just racing thoughts. So your body is not ready to calm down yet. But however, if you do get up on time at 5, eat around for 2 hours, and laugh for another 2 hours, you should have enough time winding down. We just don't have enough time for that.
Yeah, 我跟你说啊，最近啊，的确，哎呀，睡眠失灵，作息紊乱，我就觉得作息失灵这件事情啊，真的是让你没有魂灵。所以刚才听到很多医生的介绍，对我自己来说也非常受用。我最近一直在传一个粥啊，我跟你说，今天养生私房菜，四哥就教你做这个粥。看到没有？这什么？哎，不是梅干菜，这是百合，干的百合。这是大米，莲子呢？因为不多，我已经放进去了啊。我们做一个莲子粥。
Prepare 500 ml of fresh water and 50 grams of lotus seeds. Add 100 grams of rice and 50 grams of lily bulb. Simmer for 45 minutes. There you go, a bowl of lotus seeds and lily porridge.
据说喝粥啊，安神、助眠、易睡，非常好。对于我们这种就是白天现在要上班，特别是直播的时候，2个小时高度紧张。那这个晚上还要带孩子，对不对？我现在睡的状况很差，醒一会儿，睡一会儿，睡一会儿，哭一会儿，哭一会儿，再醒一会儿，醒一会儿，再哭一会儿。以前是炒股票，现在是抱小孩，所以整个状态很差。那么，还有没有什么别的办法可以让我永葆年轻？
Finally, let's come back to our patient Ye Ying. He has to take care of his baby during night. Do you have any tips or any solutions to help him?
Start with me.
Yeah,
first of all, it depends on how significant his circadian rhythm is being interrupted, and how severe his now the adrenal gland function and the rest of the hormone system now interrupted. Now the hormone system is actually has another name called the endocrine system, and most people are familiar with this.Female sexual hormones and male sexual hormones, but it's actually a lot more complex than that.
Really?
It's actually starting from the brain, where you have the hypothalamus, pituitary, there are so little glands, and you have thyroid, where most people heard of it. This actually controls your metabolism, whether you're fat or skinny, your bowel movement fast or slow, constipated or diarrhea, controlled by these. Also your hair, skin, and everything, metabolism.Forming new cells are controlled by these. And also you're dealing with pancreas. Pancreas deal with your blood sugar and also your adrenals. Adrenals sits on top of your kidneys, two little glands like walnuts. And those are control your stress level, helps you deal with the energy throughout the day.
Ye Ying came to Dr. Queenie to find out differences in adrenaline levels between different people. He learned that adrenaline levels are tested by collecting saliva in the morning, noon, afternoon, and at night.
拍摄时间下午4点，按照梅医生的规定，梅医师的规定，采样。我这个人最大的特点和弱点就是口水太少。 最近舌头也不是很灵活。哎呀，哎，你喝吧。好重啊！哇，都弯了，全是水。这个采集绝对没问题。下午这一只完成了啊，我们接下来还有晚上一只，四只送到拜耳鼻炎测试结果就会出来。
After a week of waiting, the test results came back. Yin took a trip to Dr. Quinney's clinic again. The results show that, in terms of his adrenaline level, Yin is categorized as having a sub-health condition. Lack of sleep is the major cause.
听了这个梅医师的说法，我打算回家十点钟就睡觉。如果有条件的话，下午也可以再补补觉，我不知道有没有作用。但总之一句，听了这话之后，我要改正一下自己的作息时间，好好的把自己这种肾上腺素的这个紊乱的状况要得到改进。
After Dr. Quinney's examination, Ye Ying's issues seem to ease up. At the same time, we also want to extend thanks to our foreign traditional Chinese medicine doctor, Evan.
I've always had a liking of China. China was a mystery to me when I was younger, and I would always read Chinese kung fu books and watch Chinese movies, and it was very beautiful, very fascinating. And so I decided I would.Study Chinese medicine.
For more health information, please do join our WeChat. We will offer you some tips almost every day. You can search for our official account, ICS 养生东西方, or our ID, Ways to Wellness, or you may scan the two-dimensional barcode on the screen.
必胜客新春季菜单，地道韩式甄选牛肉披萨，鲜香丰盛，澳洲进口西冷牛排，鱼子酱海鲜法式酥盒，还有意面、饮料、甜点，21款全新春季美味，快来尝鲜，和电影《里约大冒险二》一起狂欢。
上海呢，现在每年有22万到23万的女孩升级为妈妈，实际上我也是一个妈妈，所以有很多的这个经历啊。或者这种感受也是和他们是很相同的。生产的关键时刻呢，多帮一把，挽留下来的呢就是希望和幸福。但是在我们的这个工作当中呢，并不都是在紧急关头，从第一次检查的时候我们就要给他树立起一种信心，给个微笑啊，给一些肯定的支持。
这阿公就老要紧了，有点痛的要忍一忍的啊。
在这里，这些新生儿呢，他们开始了人生的第一天。在这里，我们也每一刻都感受到新的希望。
最顶尖的院校，最权威的教授，最活力的学生，最深入的体验，最有用的信息。每周六晚18点 ICS 海外路路通，敬请期待。极细线条及精致眼妆，全新美宝莲极细眼线笔，0.05毫米极细线条，勾勒精致眼妆，不晕染，轻松卸，全新美宝莲极细眼线笔。
After 50 years of diplomacy, China and France are celebrating a new chapter of bilateral relations. From wining and dining to makeup and build up, Shanghai Live takes a look at major collaborations between the two countries.Please tune in for our special series, Ni Hao Mon Ami, at 9 p.m. from May 12th to 16th, only on ICS.
SES. Attention! Now you can join our program and get professional advice from our Chinese and Western doctors. If you have health problems and want to get professional opinions, have 2 days available for filming, preferably speak a fluent English. Why hesitate? Just contact us through our WeChat and leave us your basic information, including your name, age, mobile number, health issue or symptoms that you have, as well as what medical treatment you are seeking. You might get a chance to be on our show. For more health information, please do join our WeChat. We will offer you some tips almost every day. You can search for our official account, ICS 养生东西方, or our ID, Ways to Wellness,or you may scan the two-dimensional barcode on the screen.
That's all for today's show. Thanks for your company. And all the key points will be revealed in our WeChat. You can search for our official account, ICS 养生东西方, our ID, Ways to Wellness, or you can also scan the QR code on the screen. And also, you are very welcome to write to us at wtw@ics.smd.cn. I'm He Jian. See you next Tuesday at 8:30 p.m. Bye-bye.